Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. We want to prove this power rule. Use mathematical induction. For n is an integer. The purpose here is to introduce the mathematical induction method to prove this. There are many methods to prove this power rule. N can be real numbers. There are methods, including the original definition for the derivative. And also, if you use the derivative definition, you can use the binomial formula to simplify it if the power n is an integer. So here, we only use n as an integer so that we can use mathematical induction. Why mathematical induction method is important? In lots of math result theory proofs, it is very powerful, simple, efficient if we can use mathematical induction. When you prove a mathematical result, if mathematical induction is an option, you should try it first. What is the mathematical induction? The first step, we need proof this result is true at the starting point. What is the starting point? Here we are assuming n is an integer, positive. So which one is the smallest positive integer? N equals one. So we need to check if n equals one, this result, if it is true. N equals one, left hand side is derivative of x to the power one equals one times x to the power one minus one. The power is zero. X to the power zero is one. So the right hand side should be equal to one. From the definition of derivative, we know that the derivative of x equals one. Rewrite this in this way. Derivative of x to the power one, which is x, equals one, it's one here, times x to the power one minus one. One minus one is zero. X to the power zero is one. So it is one, same as right-hand side, left-hand side is the same. So here, when x equals one, this general result is true. Just replace n by one. So x to the power one is here. Right-hand side as one, one as n times n minus one, one minus one. This power rule, when x equals one, it is true. Now, second step, based on the induction logic, if n equals k is true, can you derive when n equals k plus one, this result is also true. So we are assuming n equals k, it is true. That means the derivative of x to the power k equals k times x to the power k minus one. We need to use this to derive this result. The derivative of x to the power k plus one we can rewrite as a product of x to the power k times x. Use the product rule from calculus. So here, the product rule is this. The derivative of the first term times the second term plus the derivative of first term times the derivative of second term. The derivative of first term, which is derivative of x to the power k. we can use the assumption when n equals k, we are assuming this case is true from the power rule. So that's k times x to the power k minus 1. Then times x, x is outside, plus x to the power k times the derivative of x, which is 1. Simplify, we have kx to the power k plus x to the power k. So we only have x to the power k here. Here's k, here's 1. Put them together, it's k plus 1. So k plus 1, x to the power k. X to the power k is equivalent to k plus 1 minus 1. We need to rewrite this kind of format to compare with the original result. So original result is this, n, here's n minus 1. So here, if we have k plus 1, here should be k plus 1 minus 1. So here, when n equals k plus 1, this result is also true. You can see here, if n equals k plus 1, we have k plus 1 here, k plus 1 here, and k plus 1 here, k plus 1 here. Here is the conclusion. For any n, if n is a positive integer, the power rule is always true. That's all. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.